Hi guys, I am here with your Bible reading. I hope you guys are having a good day. What? What? Why was you doing that for then? Sherm's being weird again.
Again?
Yeah. What are you doing? Looks like it's gonna rain.
It's already rained today. You missed it.
Is it raining where you guys are at? We live in Ohio. I guess it's been raining all morning.
Ohio.
And it looks really rainy again, and it's really windy.
It's windy.
Leave the blind open, babe. He's such a brat. Leave that one closed or I won't be able to see to you. See what I mean?
You see what I mean?
Sit down. In your chair. We're not gonna start this.
We already did.
He's gonna start mocking me.
Where do we go? Where'd I go? There I am!
Sit down. You're not a freaking Jack in the Box. Sit down.
There I am!
Sit down.
No.
Sit down.
No.
You're not a Jack in the Box.
Ribbit!
I didn't turn the lever.
Ribbit!
Stay down.
Ribbit!
You're not a frog, Sherm. You're not a cat either. You're not a puppy. Sit. Come in front of the camera so everybody can see you. They want to see you do that. Get in front of the camera. Get in front of the camera.
Yeah, it made me look retarded on me. Facebook.
How did I do that? How did I do that?
You know what you did.
No, seriously, what did I do?
You know what you did.
I didn't put nothing on Facebook.
Yeah, you did.
What did I put on there? I put stuff on Instagram.
You put it on Facebook, too.
What? What did I put on there? I put the bunny on there. I knew I put mine on there.
But it wasn't me being the bunny. It was me being me.
It didn't even show your bunny.
No, it showed me, not the bunny.
Why? Why did it take the bunny out? Where'd the bunny go? You know the Snapchat where it dresses you up in the bunny costume? And it claps its hands and dancing all around. I guess it took Sherm out of the bunny costume and he was just dancing all around, clapping his hands. And I guess I apparently shared it to Facebook yesterday and Sherm was just there with his shirt off, clapping his hands, dancing all around with no bunny costume on. Just dancing around with his shirt off, looking like a moron for everybody to see. Everybody probably wondering why.
That's off my meds.
Anybody call me on?
No, said thank God.
I'm sure we'll get some comments. I didn't know I shared that.
You did.
I don't know. It must be sharing stuff automatically because, Myrtle told Cindy the other day that she thought it was so funny because she seen a picture that I posted of Sherm in a rocket. And I didn't know what she was talking about. So apparently I posted a picture of you in a rocket too. I don't know.
Ooh.
I think it's starting to post stuff automatically. I don't know what's going on. Snapchat. Okay, guys. Let's get to the Bible reading. Today we are going to be reading, we're still in Luke chapter 8. We'll be reading verses 40, reading through chapter 9, verse 6. You'll be seeing Jesus raise a dead girl, and you'll be seeing people laugh at Jesus, you know, thinking he's, this guy's stupid, she's not asleep, she's dead. You know, he's a fool to think she's only sleeping. This girl is clearly dead. We know a dead girl when we see her. And you'll see a woman that has been bleeding really bad for 12 years, bleeding in a way she should not be bleeding. And she's very, very sick with it. It's made her very, very sick. And she's dying from it. And she knew if she just touched even a piece of the clothes Jesus was wearing, that she would be healed. And when she seen Jesus in the crowd one day, she was able to touch just the edge of his cloak. And from that moment, she was healed. So you'll see that today. And you'll see Jesus sending out the 12 disciples to go out and start healing people. And then, of course, we have our psalm. And then we have a few proverbs. And if you'd like to follow along, we'll be reading in the New International Version. And I'll try to do the best I can. My lungs are still horrible. I can't remember if I took that mucus pill or not. I think I did. I just wheeze day and night constantly. So bad at nighttime. If it wasn't for VapoRub, I don't know what I would do. I wouldn't be able to breathe. So my inhalers and VapoRub and I need, you know, prednisone. I need my steroids. It's the only thing that helps my lungs. This rattle and wheeze so bad. All right. Anyways, let's get started. Now, when Jesus returned, a crowd welcomed him, for they were all expecting him. Then a man named Jairus, a synagogue leader, came and fell at Jesus' feet, pleading with him to come to his house, because his only daughter, a girl of about 12, was dying. As Jesus was on his way, the crowds almost crushed him, and a woman was there who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years, but no one could heal her. She came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak, and immediately her bleeding stopped. "Who touched me?" Jesus asked. When they all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the people are crowding and pressing against you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me. I know that power has gone out from me." Then the woman, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, came trembling and fell at his feet. In the presence of all the people, she told why she had touched him and how she had been instantly healed. Then he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace." While Jesus was still speaking, someone came from the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader. "Your daughter is dead," he said, "Don't bother the teacher anymore." Hearing this, Jesus said to Jairus, "Don't be afraid, just believe, and she will be healed." When he arrived at the house of Jairus, he did not let anyone go in with him except Peter, John, and James, and the child's father and mother. Meanwhile, all the people were wailing and mourning for her. "Stop wailing," Jesus said. "She is not dead, but asleep." They laughed at him, knowing that she was dead. But he took her by the hand and said, "My child, get up." Her spirit returned, and at once she stood up. Then Jesus told them to give her something to eat. Her parents were astonished, but he ordered them not to tell anyone what had happened. When Jesus had called the 12 together, he gave them power and authority to drive out all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He told them, "Take nothing for the journey, no staff, no bag, no bread, no money, no shirt. Whatever house you enter, stay there until you leave that town. If people do not welcome you, leave their town and shake the dust off your feet as a testimony against them." So they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and healing people everywhere. And that is where we're going to stop with the book of Luke today, guys. Excuse me if I get a drink really quick. My lungs, the mucus is really, really bad. Oh, so embarrassing. Oh, my lungs are... I've been coughing, you know, a lot too. I don't know if some kind of cough syrup would help, you know. I haven't had took any kind of cough syrup in years. Years. I'm sure maybe it'd probably help with the coughing, but would it help with the wheezing? That's the main thing I'm trying to, you know. The wheezing and not being able to, you know, breathe good when it gets bad. And it's worse, the most worse at night. So, I'm gonna look for some kind of cough syrup, I think, and try it maybe. Okay, let's see here. Our psalm today is Psalm 71, and it has, I think, about 23, 24 verses in it. So let's begin. In you, Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your righteousness, rescue me and deliver me. Turn your ear to me and save me. Be my rock of refuge, to which I can always go. Give the command to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the grasp of those who are evil and cruel. For you have been my hope, Sovereign Lord, my confidence since my youth. From birth I have relied on you. You brought me forth from my mother's womb. I will ever praise you. I have become a sign to many. You are my strong refuge. My mouth is filled with your praise, declaring your splendor all day long. Do not cast me away when I am old. Do not forsake me when my strength is gone, for my enemies speak against me. Those who wait to kill me conspire together. They say God has forsaken him. Pursue him and seize him, for no one will rescue him. Do not be far from me, my God. Come quickly, God, to help me. May my accusers perish in shame. May those who want to harm me be covered with scorn and disgrace. As for me, I will always have hope. I will praise you more and more. My mouth will tell of your righteous deeds, of your saving acts all day long. Though I know not how to relate them all, I will come and proclaim your mighty acts, Sovereign Lord. I will proclaim your righteous deeds, yours alone. Since my youth, God, you have taught me, and to this day I declare your marvelous deeds. Even when I am old and gray, do not forsake me, my God, till I declare your power to the next generation, your mighty acts to all who are to come. Your righteousness, God, reaches to the heavens. You who have done great things, who has like you, God? Though you have made me see troubles, many and bitter, you will restore my life again. From the depths of the earth, you will again bring me up. You will increase my honor and comfort me once more. I will praise you with my heart for your faithfulness, my God. I will sing praise to you with the lyre. Holy One of Israel, my lips will shout for joy. When I sing praise to you, I, whom you have delivered, my tongue will tell of your righteous acts all day long. For those who wanted to harm me have been put to shame and confusion. And that is Psalm the 71. Okay, guys. And our Proverbs today is Proverbs chapter 12, verses 5, 6, and 7. The plans of the righteous are just, but the advice of the wicked is deceitful. The words of the wicked lie in wait for blood, but the speech of the upright rescues them. The wicked are overthrown and are no more, but the house of the righteous stands firm. Okay, guys, that was our Bible reading. I hope it touched your guys' hearts. We are going to do our prayer request today. I got our prayer book. What's the time?
19.
All right, we got time. All right, let's see here. I got a couple updates, and I added a person to the list, marked a couple people off. Okay, so we can mark Pam off the list in case you haven't been here. Pam has passed away from liver cancer, so she is no longer with us. She has passed away. It's been a little while now, but I wanted to mention it again in case you haven't been with us with the Bible readings. Please keep her family in your prayers. Please keep Margie and Chuck Sickles in your prayers. Please keep Eric in your prayers. Eric needs a kidney. Did you hear that? That's what my computer does all day, all throughout the day. That loud tugboat sound. And it says, cannot find script file. Windows script toast. I don't know what it's talking about. Anyway, sorry. Please keep Macy in your prayers. Macy is 16 and she has a brain tumor. Please keep Christopher Serback in your prayers. Please keep Miranda and Jeremy Caverly in your prayers. Please keep April and Linda Thacker in your prayers. Please keep Sherman Crabtree in your prayers. Please keep Debbie Lee in your prayers. Please keep Lonnie Dolls Jr. in your prayers. Please keep Luann Dolls and family in your prayers. Please keep Bridget Boggs and family in your prayers. Please keep Rhonda Karshner in your prayers. Shannon and her son Giovanni. Ramona Henry. Patty Haynes. Barb Post. She is home. My stepmom. And she's got a colostomy bag now. She's not able to get around on her own. Cindy Welsh. Dora Carper. Abby Myers. She had her surgery. They put her to sleep yesterday and took out 5 teeth. 4 wisdom teeth and another tooth. She's doing well. They wrote her off school till the 4th, though. But she's doing well. So update on that. So thank you for the prayers. Please continue to pray for Abby Myers. And please pray for Jimmy Myers. Please pray for Chrissy. Chrissy's going through a lot. Norma Boyer, she's got cancer. Please pray for her. Garnet Boyer, Ariana Lloyd, Norman Karshner. Our grandma Doris Thompson. I told you guys, and if you don't remember, we just found out she's got cancer all through her, and she doesn't have much time left, so please keep her in prayer. And that is Barb's mom. Mindy Gallimore, Melody Ramey, Tammy Ashworth, Sandy, and Rosie, Roy and Lori Mollett, all the homeless people and animals, Kenny Wellman, and Kim and family, and Paris Jude, and Dr. Shoemaker is out of the hospital doing well and is back to work, of course, because he's the one that did Abby surgery yesterday. So great news for him too, because as you know, he was in the hospital and almost died. So he's doing great. So thank you guys for all the prayers. We hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Let's bring those souls to Jesus, and God willing, we'll see you guys again tomorrow with another Bible reading. Bye, guys. God bless.